So we're going to take a little break now, but we'll be right back in a few moments for the ladies' final. But I'm sure both of them have got butterflies in their tummies and are feeling very nervous indeed. Both players have practiced on the outside courts, both players have warmed up, and it is the ambition of both of them to win this French Open for the second time. There's the trophy, the Suzanne Lenglen trophy, which will be presented a little later on, probably in an hour and a half or 2 hours' time. Plus an enormous amount of prize money, $400,000 of prize money, and all the prestige that goes with it. But it's really the titles that these two players are after. They have both won this tournament before. Monica Seles won it last year, and the pretty young lady in your picture, Arantxa Sanchez Vicario, as ever, smiling, she won it in 1989. Formalities of the umpire, tossing the coin, just giving one of them the choice whether or not to serve or to receive. Just saying a few words to them, perhaps saying, well, try and accept our decisions. It's not easy for the linesman to make these calls, but let's hope it's a good match. Good luck to both of you. The coin is tossed. Monica and Arantxa just asked by the photographers for one last photograph. There we are. That will flash across all the newspapers around the world, particularly in Yugoslavia for Monica Seles and Spain for Arantxa Sanchez, because one really associates Monica Seles with America. She's been over living in Florida since she was very, very young, 12 years old, and speaks with a very high-pitched American accent, or a mixture, shall I say, of a Yugoslavian broken and American accent. And I certainly associate her with being an American, but she's from originally from Yugoslavia, and Arantxa Sanchez, obviously, as we all know, from Spain. So the photographic opportunities are over. The centre court here with 16,500 people will gradually fill up. It's a nervous time for both of them. Both are now just warming up on this very, very nice and manicured European clay court. Monica Seles, a mere 17 years of age, 1.75 meters, resides in Sarasota in the United States, seeded number one here before these championships, and also number one on the WITA, that's the Women's International Tennis Association computer ranking. Has only lost one set so far in these championships, where against Sandra Cecchini from Italy, she was a set 6-3 and 2-love down, but then won 12 of the next 13 games to go through 6-love in the third, and then has not really dropped a set, as you see on your captions, since then. So only dropped one set in this whole championships. 28 games she's lost, that's all, by getting to the final. So a very good performance by Monica Seles, as would be expected. The defending champion won last year in a remarkable run of tournaments, and took over from Steffi Graf in March this year in the number one women's ranking position. Steffi Graf having been number one for 104 weeks. So the little girl from Spain, a little older, 19 years of age, 1.69 meters in height, resides in Andorra with the famous Sanchez family. Her brother, two brothers, Xavier and Emilio, both ardent supporters of hers, and also we mustn't forget the other sister, Marisa. Well, Arantxa's had an even better run to the final. She's only lost 19 games and has not dropped one set, and only once has she gone to 6-3 against Mary Jo Fernandez. All the other matches she's won have been in two games, or one game, or six love sets. So that is a remarkable record, particularly the semi-final beating Steffi Graf. Fairly unexpectedly, I think that one has to say, 6-love, 6-2. Poor Steffi Graf didn't play very well, but take nothing away from Arantxa Sanchez, who played very well indeed. The aerial view of Stade Roland Garros this wonderful stadium full of tradition and history. And not an easy time for the umpire, Mr. Merlet from France, who also, I'm sure, will be slightly nervous away as well, because it's a big day to umpire this match for him. He's obviously got to keep total control of this match. He's got to overrule the line calls if any of the linesmen make mistakes. And he's got to hold on to the confidence of the players. And what a lovely, bubbly personality Arantxa Sanchez is. She just seems to enjoy life completely, doesn't she? Monica Seles, a little bit more tenser than the Spaniard, but very, very determined. An extraordinary, almost unique personality, I think, Monica Seles. So gutsy, so determined. Hits every ball at 100%, grunts every time she plays, and really plays as if she just hates that ball and wants to get rid of it as soon as it hits her racket. Very engaging personality in the many, many press conferences and television interviews that she's had after each one of her matches. And there's no doubt that one is seeing the most determined player probably in the world today, Monica Seles. Great privilege for us to be here. And I hope you enjoy the coverage of Eurosport this afternoon, as perhaps you've been during all this fortnight here at the French Open. So, Monsieur Merlet is introducing the players, and a very warm reception one will get for both players. Philippe Chatrier, next door to the trophies in the white Mac, the president of the French Federation. Recently, Mr. Chatrier elected onto the Olympic Committee.
Avec jeu décisif dans les deux premières, le tirage au sort a été gagné par Mademoiselle Sanchez Vicario, qui a choisi de recevoir.
So, the scene is set here at the French Open.
Un de l'échauffement. Préparez-vous, Mademoiselle.
Defending champion Monica Seles versus Arantxa Sanchez Vicario. On paper, one has to say that this young lady, minus the normal pigtails, as you may have seen, is favourite to win this match. She's played her four times in the past, and all four have resulted in victories for Monica Seles. However, Arantxa Sanchez is good at upsetting the form books, because before she played Steffi Graf, she'd lost seven times in a row, but she's beaten her yesterday, or the day before yesterday, very convincingly. Sit back and I hope you enjoy our coverage. Monica Seles, left-handed, two-handed both sides, the most extraordinary player against Arantxa Sanchez. It's a tactic that she's been using a lot all fortnight, the disguised drop shot. That's a great shot. Nothing players like more very early in a match than to hit the ball right in the middle of the sweet spot of the racket, and that's a very, very good forehand. Oh. Sanchez Vicario has been scrapping and defending and messing her opponents around all week in a very positive way. She will move Monica Seles around from side to side. And a good start from the Spaniard, giving her first break point. There it is, the error from Seles, giving a good start to Arantxa Sanchez Vicario. So, the senior set, we're going to take a little break, stay with us, because let's go back and see whether Sanchez Vicario can win her serve. Breaking Monica Seles' serve, one love in the first set. Yes, just out. Very good length and a very good volley. I think if there is a slight difference between both these players, that Arantxa Sanchez is slightly more of a rounded player, slightly more less weaknesses and volleys better than Seles. Likes to come to the net, as you see there with that forehand topspin volley. Very confident start. Oh! The umpire, Mr. Nerlay, just asking the linesman to confirm. And the umpire decided to give two balls. And Arantxa Sanchez walking very quickly there. Very good ace down the line. Oh, a great shot. That's a very, very well played from Arantxa Sanchez. Incredible how she even managed to get one of those shots used so wide. And what a start for the Spaniard. There's the drop shot and completely outfoxing Monica Seles. Great start for the Spaniard. Love to. The right shot, although it didn't work. You can see already that Sanchez Vicario, his tactics are going to be to bring Monica Seles into the net. Monica prefers to stay on the baseline and hammer them from side to side. And the players all fortnight are querying, quite rightly in a way, all the balls. But normally the linesman comes up and then puts his left or right hand out in a very positive way. There have been very, very few. few number of overrules by the umpire. Mr. Merlet has decided to go with the linesman's call. Sanchez felt the ball was on the line. So many balls are just missing. Well, again, you saw the ball just being called out. Monica Seles manages to get a game. There's Mrs. Sanchez Vicario, as ever, on the stands watching her daughter. And I think the families play a very important part in both these young ladies, as they do in many of the players here, particularly with this young lady, Sanchez Vicario, who always seems to me to be probably one of the most well-balanced of the players in the top of the women's rankings. Has a brother, Emilio, and Javier, as well as a sister, Marisa. And also Monica Seles has her parents here as well. They travel around with her. Two delightful young ladies. But Arantxa Sanchez in particular, I mean, with her brothers and sisters, family of tennis in Spain. Done marvelous things for Spanish tennis. Emilio in the top 10 of the world, Javier in the top 50 of the world, and her sister Marisa, also a very good player. Very strong family ties, which is very good when these young ladies travel around the world, because they're so young, they're so wealthy, they're winning so much prize money, so much endorsements, so much publicity. It's very important to keep a balanced life, and parents come in very useful. 2-1. This is interesting, isn't it? The umpire has overruled the call. The linesman didn't put his hand out. And players just do not like the umpire overruling at all. Well, Mr. Merlet puts his fingers up and says, well, 2 inches, but that's a difficult call. If it's that close, it's very difficult for the umpire to call that because it's a long way away from him. Sanchez Vicario, determined not to lose any concentration. 15-0. Oh. Yes, well played. And you can see how grueling the rallies are going to be this afternoon for both players. Both players very fit indeed, used to long, arduous rallies. Monica Seles just waiting for that short ball and pouncing on it with a two-handed backhand. Back of serve for Monica Seles. Just a couple of unforced errors from Sanchez Vicario, who started this match in a very, very high standard. Packed crowd here at Roland Garros. All square to all. Little high. No, and she's missed it. Oh, one can see that the drop shot's going to be an important play from Arantxa Sanchez today. Let off the hook there. Length on the line. Another drop shot. No, and the ball was out. Well, physically, if this match continues like this, which I'm sure it will, the physical fitness of both these players is going to come into play later on in this match. Drop shot just being played gently down the line, going for the pass, but the ball just out. What, about three or four or five, maybe? Very close call that she's had so far. Nope, just out. Arantxa had to go for the winner there because she was just travelling too far. She couldn't stop herself. So this match has started in amazing fast pace for both players. Difficulty of playing Monica Seles. She's just unrepentant in the hard-hitting shots from this two-handed sides, two-handed backhand, two-handed forehand. Just hates to lose one point. So, Seles manages to get the last three games. Mr. and Mrs. Seles looking on in delight. We're going to take a little break. Stay with us. We'll be back in a few moments.
Roland Garros per un avvenimento d'eccezione, una partita molto ben giocata dalle due protagoniste, una finale nella quale abbiamo Monica Seles in testa per tre giochi a due. Monica
being two love down, suddenly won three games in a row. 2-3, first set. Well played. Forcing Monica Seles there to hit the one-handed forehand instead of her normal two-handed. Again, the one-handed shot the second time, and then the nice disguised drop shot. Those girls using the drop shot to great effect. Obviously, Monica Seles gets more power with her two-handed shots than her one-handed shot, but that little one just to get nice bit of control on the ball. Amazing the pace that Seles keeps up, isn't it? Oh, that's a marvellous two-handed cross-court backhand after such a long rally. The physical demands on both these youngsters is great, and to come out with a shot like that after the long rally is quite remarkable. She's a tough little fighter, Sanchez Vicario. There's no doubting the will and determination and gutsy character of this one on your screen, but Sanchez Vicario, she's also very determined. Nope, just out. So she stopped the rot, having been two love up and then finding herself three games to two down. She wins the serve. High standard final so far. Neither player wanting to give an inch. 3-3. Sitting at home, you can hear the grunts of Monica Seles. She's always had that grunt, right from a very, very young age. Tried to get rid of it, but has been unable to. And really, it's now accepted completely by players. Doesn't put them off. Very few complaints about it. Just look at that. Ho, ho, ho! José Higueras on the left and Jim Courier. Jim Courier, who's in the men's singles final tomorrow against Andre Agassi. Looking nice and relaxed. Perhaps a little doubt in both players' mind about that last call, whether or not it was going to be called out, but Monica Seles, obviously only ever picking up one ball, asking the ball boy for the second one. Again the drop shot, the wrong footing drop shot again, sending her opponent the wrong way. Just look at it again on the slow motion. It's the control that she gets on that shot. Well, both players can be very satisfied with their form, although they haven't got time really to gloat on any form. They're thinking about what they're going to do in the next game. It's remarkable how young these players are. So when Sanchez Vicario won the French Open 2 years ago, she was the youngest ever winner. But then last year Monica Seles won it when she was 16 years of age. She became the youngest player, the youngest lady ever to win the French Open Championships.
Quattro giochi a tre nella finale di Roland Garros, una partita bellissima. In palio oggi, oltre naturalmente al prestigioso titolo del
Chris Evert. Both very engaging personalities. Good match so far, 3-4. Probably do her conference a lot of good, and perhaps will remind her that she's got to come to the net a little bit more. Not easy when Seles is moving around from side to side, but she does volley well. Gets a lot of control over her ground strokes, Sanchez Vicario. Forced errors coming from the racket of Arantxa Sanchez. So an opportunity for Monica Seles to go 5-3 with a break point. Such a good shot. And that's what I mean about the determination and aggression of Monica Seles. She just seems to be able to have a sixth sense of opportunity. It's a second serve. She can see that Arantxa Sanchez is struggling a little bit. Just hits the ball straight down the line. Nope, just out. Well, there was the volley. She did well, actually, to get it, although it was a little high. Thought for 1 minute she was going to go straight at the body, but... perhaps they would have if they were men. I know a couple of men that would have gone straight for the middle there. Yes, Arantxa left the ball a little short. And that's one thing you cannot do against Monica Seles. You've got to keep up a good length, unfortunately. She just pounces on anything around the service box area. So, from being two love down, Monica Seles finds herself in the enviable position of having three set points. Decided to loop it and take the pace off the ball. Went for the angle, cross court, didn't quite come off, but worth a try. Still two set points. There it is, the double-handed forehand with so much power and accuracy. Monica Seles, this determined young lady from Yugoslavia, winning the first set, 6-3. So, what a player around Monica Seles is. Absolutely unique style, basically left-handed player. But two-handed wing on both wings. Who would have thought that a style like that could go straight to the number one rankings? Always been the most determined player. Came to Florida when she was very young. Has always been a good player. Originally coached by Nick Bollettieri, but no longer. Bollettieri now coaches Andre Agassi and many of the other young players. Very strong parental background. Father a cartoonist, always at the side of Monica, and always in the stands watching the matches. Very awkward style. Probably many coaches when she was young would have said, well, with that type of style, she could never, ever reach the top of the world rankings, which she has done. But it just shows you that style really doesn't matter. It's the guts and the determination that do matter. So, Arantxa Sanchez, having lost the first set, 6-3. As ever, the ground staff being very busy in the 92nd changeover. The court perfectly manicured, swept, all ready for play in the second set. Bad luck. They both did so well. Arantxa Sanchez putting an incredible amount of spin on one of those balls, which we'll see in the slow motion. There was one drop shot, two-handed. Look at that spin there. The ball bounces to the right immediately, but she alters the footwork and then hits the smash. But Arantxa Sanchez, as ever, has got wonderful anticipation, but can't quite put it back down the line. Great rally there, wasn't it? Oh, that's a great shot. No, the ball just called out. The mark very clearly out. Uses a very, very tightly strung racket. Great defending from Sanchez Vicario, but unable to stop the barrage of forehands and backhands of Monica Seles. She really is such a difficult player to play against because every ball comes back at you at 100% effort. That is a typical European clay court shot. Great control. All the Sanchez family been born and bred almost on these courts.
Oh.
good call, but Monica Seles is just going to go and check it. That's the benefit of the ground staff sweeping the courts in between the changeovers. So there's very few marks on it. Makes it easier for the linesman. Yes, just out, and again she circles the line, only a couple of inches out. Good game from Sanchez Vicario. She finds herself a set down, but one love up in the second set. We'll be right back.
Alberto di Monaco, dietro di lui Ken Roswell e davanti Philippe Chatrier.
Back to the French Open. Monica Seles, love one in the second set.
6-3 in suo favore, 1-0 per Arancia Sanchez.
Incredible shot. Both players absolutely flat out, 100% from both players. The pace that they're hitting these balls, there was the slow one just to get back into the middle of the court to get a position, and there was the cross-court forehand shot. Can't tell you the pace that these two are playing at. Easy to concentrate every single rally when you're playing against Seles, because she plays at a very fast pace. Got 25 seconds between each point, but she likes just to hurry up, rather like a fast express train. Just wants to get on with every ball. Yes, well played. Very important for when you're playing Seles, I feel, from some of the girls that play her, just to slow the game down a little bit. That Sanchez Vicario thought that she was going to go cross-court with that two-handed passing shot. There was the short one coming in down the line. A little short perhaps, but still wasn't too bad, was it? What a pass. Got to be the play from Sanchez Vicario point of view, looping it a little bit short, moving Seles wide, opening up the court.
Oh,
You have to have a little chuckle to yourself, don't you, when watching this match, how good these two players are from the baseline. A chuckle in respect, I would say. Forced errors creeping in. Monica Seles, as ever, quickly. Everything she does is quick. Speaks quickly, serves quickly, hits quickly. Likes to get on with the match. Too high, and she's picked the wrong side. Oh, bad luck. Well, it's the drop shot that's been successful so far to Sanchez Vicario. She's therefore, I think on that shot, she just went a little bit too high. She couldn't believe that Monica Seles was going to run back for it. Worth a try, although it didn't come off. Where her unorthodoxy takes shape. Just look at this shot. I don't know whether we're going to see it on the slow motion. Probably not. There's no time. But great footwork running around her backhand, thumping that two-handed shot down the line. Ladies, the argument being, well, the men play five sets and the ladies play three. Should they get equal prize money or not? Change of linesmen. All very smart in their blazers and ties. French Federation. Everyone in this championship doing a great job here in presenting the whole of this French Open Championships in such wonderful style.
Errori pochi, in verità, commessi dalle due signore che stanno dando vita a questa stupenda finale.
She like Zaire coming into the reckoning this year for the first time televising the French Championships. Well, certainly this young lady, since she's burst onto the scenes a few years ago, has created a tremendous amount of interest. Zero. So a little bit of a chance now for the Spaniard. And a real opportunity. Monica Seles' first double fault. Vicario, three break points for a 3-1 lead. Amazing tennis from Sanchez Vicario, so determined. Good break of serve to lead 3-1. Monica Seles unusually hitting a couple of one-handed shots as opposed to two. But that's what you've got to try and do when you play Seles. You've got to push her wide enough for her not to play two-handed. It's not easy. She just wants to get on with that next game. 3-1. Check the mark, which means that the umpire, Mr. Merle, is undecided. Well, will he overrule his linesman? And I think... Well, he's getting himself in a bit of a jam here because, yes, and he says that the ball was good. Well, I suppose that's good umpiring if he definitely thought the linesman had made a mistake. What tends to happen here all fortnight is that the linesmen have said out and then there's been a query and they've come out and never... said they are not sure about the decision. They've always put their right or left hand out and said the ball was out. But there was an overall. Monica Seles not too upset, so perhaps the ball was good. And that's a very good second ace. Suddenly, Sanchez Vicario is looking good. 3 points to be 4-1. Mrs. Sanchez Vicario, probably with fingers crossed, legs crossed, toes crossed. Enough matches with Monica. Very important game this for Sanchez Vicario. You get so few opportunities from Seles to capitalize on the break of serve. Thank you. the drop shot. Yes, it's in. And there's another one. And the ball's just out, and well played to Sanchez Vicario. And has to give enormous credit to both players. Stay with us, because we're going to be right back in a few moments. Final here at Roland Garros. A very intriguing situation we now have. Monica Seles taking the first set 6-3, having been two love down. And now Sanchez Vicario firmly in the driving seat at 4-1 in the second set. There's the drop shot, again with a lot of spin, so when the ball touches the ground it goes back in towards the net. I thought the topspin lob was going to be the shot because she was so close to the net, but she's done some running today, hasn't she? Play. Seles really plays every point the same, whether she's love 40, 40 love, 1-4 down, 4-1 up. She was a set and two love down in the early rounds to Ciccini from Italy, and then suddenly won 12 out of the 13 games. Yes. Oh. Well, again, Monsieur Mollet is asking the mark to be checked, and the umpire, as ever, puts his left or right hand out. That's what they all do. It's just a pattern that's been there the whole of the 2 weeks. Well, he's going to have a look, you see, which means that automatically Monsieur Mollet has indicated to both the players that he actually is not sure himself. No, just out, he says. The merest inch. Well, at least he's had a look at the mark, and that's good from the player's point of view. Still with break, 4-2. It's a little bit of indecision there from Sanchez Vicario. I don't think she was too sure whether she was going to smash it, whether she was going to hit a topspin volley, whether she was going to let it bounce. Paid the price. That's a good shot. Taking the ball early on the rise, not giving so there's an opportunity to get back to play that shot. Seles muttering away for herself as ever. Sudden change of shot, change of pace, hitting what, 5, 6, 7 topspin backhands two-handed, and suddenly changing to a one-handed slice backhand, and that's where the error came in. It just doesn't stop, does it, Seles? It just carries on and on all day long. And there's the break back. And from a physical point of view, Seles will not give up. She's very fit, very strong. Had a day off yesterday, didn't play any matches, whereas Sanchez Vicario was in the semi-final of both the mixed doubles and the ladies' doubles. So from a physical point of view, one has to say that Seles is perhaps in slightly, I don't mean better shape, that she's physically better, but that she's had the advantage of having a day off. It's fun. Right, 3-4. Second set. That's well played. The game before, she missed one of those smashes without letting it bounce, so that time she remembered it and let the ball bounce and hit the shot exactly like a serve. Taking her time. Good shot. And that's a very nicely controlled topspin forehand cross court. Oh, that is a wonderful shot. A little bit of an advantage, being two-handed, gets a little bit more control over the shot with two hands. There it is. Keeps two hands on the rackets that time. Well played. The important thing that Sanchez Vicario did was
Once she played the drop shot which was there, she anticipated where Seles was going to go. She was already on her way and then just had to play it back down the line. Seles cursing herself for not going straight down the line. She gets this point or gets this game. It'll be the second time that she's pulled three games in a row. It's a little short. Oh, off the line. Seles is... No. She says the ball just touched the outside edge of the line. Such a good rally from both players, though. Incredible how Sanchez Vicario got that. That was another drop shot. And just look at this. The ball just touched the outside edge of the line, didn't bounce up at all. To Monica Seles, three games in a row for the second time in this match. Sanchez Vicario just letting her off the hook. First set, Seles was two love down and won three games in a row. And then she was 4-1 down in this set and has won the same. Amazing character, Monica Seles. Suddenly the unforced errors are creeping in. The frustration of being 4-1 up, it's easily done, isn't it? You just want to will yourself to win this match so badly. And against someone like Seles, you find yourself having to try that little bit too hard. And that's what she's done this last two, 3 points. So three break points now for Monica Seles. And there's the other unforced error. And from 4-1 down, Monica Seles finds herself 5-4 up. She's going to have to find it very difficult to come out now when Monica Seles is going to serve for the match. Stay with us, we'll be right back in a few moments.
Il servizio di Monica Seles, 6-3, 5-4 in favore della giocatrice jugoslava, alla quale servono 4 piccoli punti.
Champion serving for the match. And the errors are just streaming off her racket now. Oh. Well, Arantxa went the right way, but with such power that she gets, and she generates so much power off these two-handed shots, wasn't there a chance at all, was there? So, total dominance at the moment for Monica Seles. That's a good shot. And the difficulty is that she knows it, that at these latter stages of the match, she's going to have to continue to raise a game like shot with shots like this. Not the easiest thing in the world to do, is it? 30-15. Yes. Great play. She's raised her game. 17-shot rally. With the final winner down the line of this very, very nice two-handed backhand. Good footwork, good weight distribution. Getting her body weight into the two-handed backhand. Down the line, making it 30-all. Still got some tennis left in this match or not? I've talked about the fighting qualities of Seles a lot, but I'll take nothing away from this young lady. Break point. Yes. Oh, well played. One's got to give enormous credit to Seles. She never stops running. Incredible to think that last year she had match points against her and then managed to win the championships. She had match points against her in the Australian Open early this year and then won that as well. Juice. Nope. And Sanchez Vicario is hanging on. All she's worth. Second opportunity to break the serve of Seles. She looks ready to go, doesn't she? Well, that's an interesting serve, isn't it? Monica Seles is always thinking. I mean, a very good serve to do. Suddenly she's game point down and pops up with a serve down the line like that, forcing the error. Back to juice. Ah!
Yes.
Sanchez Vicario did well, actually, to get it. Just look at her. She's saying, give me that ball, give me that ball. Locking away to herself. And the defending champion has her first match point. Sanchez Vicario not quite ready. Just taking her time, getting her concentration, getting herself focused. Nope. It was a very risky drop shot to do at that stage. The down the line shot was completely open. She went for the outright winner back across court. Juice. Ah. Well, it's easily done, but it's such a shame. So, Seles now, again, wanted just to get on with the match. Second match point. Well, she's a tough little cookie, isn't she, this one? Sanchez Vicario, an engaging personality, lovely character, a lot of fun, and a lot of determination. She's missed it. Now, this is where Monica Seles should really take her time. I wonder if she will. The third break point that Arantxa Sanchez has had to break the Seles serve. And that's a very good shot. Great control over that backhand. Look at the serve. It took Arantxa very, very far out, completely out of the tram lines. There was the two-handed shot with a little bit of spin. Hitting the ground and hardly bouncing up at all. Back to juice. She decides to change the tactic and to go down the line. Lost a little bit of patience. So easy to do against Seles, who is quite happy to hit grand strokes cross court as long as possible. Right, third match point for Monica Seles. A remarkable, remarkable rally, showing the strength of character of both these two players. Absolutely amazing rally here. Physically, I don't know how they can carry on as they are, but Arantxa Sanchez holding on to her nerve, coming in on the right time and putting the volley away.
Arantxa Sanchez saved 3 match points so far. And Seles decided not to let the ball bounce very high, decided to take it early. And paid the price of a little bit of impetuosity. And look at her, she just wants to get on with it. Why doesn't she take her time a little bit? Arantxa's going to. Arantxa Sanchez with her 3rd time that she's had a break point.
Oh.
And the point about this shot is it's virtually the same shot as she messed up the last time, only on this time it's on her forehand. Last time she did that on the backhand, applied the same tactic of taking the ball early before it bounced high off the ground. The time before she missed it, but not that time. Back to juice. Amazing, amazing rally.
Oh, well played. You've got to take your hat off to these two young ladies, haven't you? Monica Seles, the defending champion, the youngest ever winner of the French Open last year. The most determined of players.
The strength of character of both these players doesn't have to be proved, does it? 4th match point.
And there it is. Game, set, match to Monica Seles. A marvellous last game in particular, but a very good final. Thoroughly deserves to win. 6-3, 6-4, she cannot believe it. The defending champion Monica Seles wins the tournament for the 2nd time in 2 years.
And what a feeling. And she's just going to run up and I'm sure try and either try and see her parents or just gone outside the centre court for a short while.
But a great final from both players. Don't let's take anything away from Sanchez Vicario, who's had a wonderful fortnight here.
Et on va essayer de la rattraper juste à la... À la sortie des vestiaires.
Before coming to this final, Sanchez Vicario had never beaten Monica Seles, losing on 4 occasions, so was definitely the underdog. So, great final, now for the presentations.
There's the score confirmation. 1 hour and 29 minutes of excellent play from both players. Very high standard of ladies' tennis in the final. 6-3, 6-4. Monica Seles from Yugoslavia. So, all the ball boys and ball girls lining up. The rehearsals have taken place for the officials for this ceremony. Philippe Chatrier, the president of the French Federation, shortly will be organizing the presentation.
Many emotions today, hein? Combien d'émotions aujourd'hui?
Well, I mean, I really didn't think at the beginning that I would finish here twice in a row. I mean, I had such a tough draw that I had, you know, I just still can't believe it, that it really did happen.
Wait. Nous voyons sur l'interview. We'll see you in the interview room. Monica Seles, vraiment pleine d'émotions, qui nous disait que simplement pleine d'émotions, qu'elle était vraiment
there's
très contente d'avoir terminé
the
ce
Suzanne
jeu.
Long, long trophies.
Il fallait, car elle ne savait plus trop où elle en était. Avec ses différentes
balles
de match et occasions ratées que vous soulignez très très bien. Du reste, Michel et Jean-Paul, et nous retrouverons donc les deux joueurs si vous voulez bien.
Each one of the trophies named after one of the past great players of France. Suzanne Lenglen, winning the French Open Championships in 20, 21, 19, 22, and 25 and 19, 26, just for good measure. So a wonderful moment for Monica Seles, who last year was the youngest ever to have won the French Open Championships, is the current number one player in the world, and a great effort to defend her title. Great tribute to her country, Yugoslavia, although she hasn't lived there for many years. And a great applause from the 16,500 crowd. There's Philippe Chatrier on the right. The Suzanne Lenglen trophy high in the sky. And a thoroughly deserved victory for Monica Seles. She will treasure this moment for the rest of her life. Photographs will be on every newspaper around the world tomorrow. You will read and see this in your daily newspaper wherever you live in the world. And a well-deserved applause for the wonderful personality of the Spaniard Arantxa Sanchez Vicario. I'm sure her brothers, her two brothers, Javier and Emilio, will be very proud this afternoon, and also her other sister, Marisa, because it's a marvelous effort for the Sanchez family to produce such great players and such nice personalities.
First of all, thank all my supporters who have been with me the whole 2 weeks, even coming here. I really didn't think that I would be here standing. So this is just still incredible to me. Thank you so much for it, really.
Well, it's just not easy, is it, to make a speech straight after that victory?
I would like to thank Philippe Chatrier for making such a great French Open. I mean, everything is greatly done for the players, really. We couldn't ask for anything better. I'd also like to thank the French Tennis Federation. I'd like to thank Patrick Kalurkin and Kraft General Foods World Tour for sponsoring women's tennis. I would like to thank my dad, who really pulled me through this week, even I didn't believe in myself. And I just want to say, he's the greatest coach I could ever have, and I just love him for that. And I would like to thank my mom and my brother, who always called me at home and always told me over the phone what to play to whom, even though he didn't know any of my opponents. So it's kind of a dark scene tactics. I would like to thank all my friends there who supported me during this week. and I could go on because I have really so many people to thank, but most of all I would thank all of you, and I just can't believe it's two in a row, and I just can't wait to come back here. I mean, I can't ask for any better tournament than this one. I just love it, simply said. Thank you.
Great, 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 isn't it? Lovely face, lovely engaging personality. So difficult to know what to say, who to thank.
Well, she say all the sponsors, so I have to repeat anyway. Well, I have to say thank you to everybody to come to watch this final. I have to congratulate Monica. She played really well. Congratulations. And for me, it's also very good because... I'm really proud because went to the final and played so well in this wonderful tournament, and really proud. And I have to say thank you to my family to come and support me. I will try next year, and we'll see if next year I'll come back again and try for a second time. Thank you very much, and we love you.
Well, two very popular young ladies. Two girls that are so young and with such wonderful futures still ahead of them. When you think of the ages of some of the players, of Martina Navratilova, Chris Evert, who's now retired, but particularly Martina, who has won these championships before, one wonders how long these two young players can keep this type of pace up. But they certainly have enthralled us today, along with the 16,000 crowd. Philippe Chatrier on the left-hand side of your picture, the president of the French Federation and the retiring president of the International Tennis Federation. The customary photographs. Each photographer trying to get his individual picture. Mr. Mellet, the French umpire, just being presented with his little silver tray. So, Monica Seles, she looks a little different, doesn't she, without her big, long ponytail. Looks much younger. It's amazing how someone so young and can be so determined. We're going to take a little break now. We're going to come back for some more tennis in a few moments.
I was thinking of the match when I played Gabriella Sabatini and Lipton, when I had the same thing coming back from 4-love, and I got to 5-4, 6-5, and I had these long games. And
j'ai pensé en fait au match que j'ai joué au dernier, au récent tournoi Lipton contre Gabriella Sabatini, où j'étais mené 4-0 dans la deuxième manche et où je suis revenu à 5-4, resté concentré, vraiment resté sur l'affaire.
So I said, if I could have pulled that then, I have to pull it out here. And you know, I just gave it all I had because it's 30 love. My hands are starting shaking.
Oui, alors ce qui s'est passé.